Svalbard is a very special place, and especially to me. It's, you know, I've been there for 10 years and I've seen the changes through this time. And it is a unique wilderness where wildlife is in charge, not people.
My name is Helena Reinhardy, and I am an associate professor here at the University Center in Svalbard. I work in the technology department, and my research is looking at the environmental effects of pollutants on mainly marine organisms, and I specialize in fish ecotoxicology. Diving season is very short here. We only have a few months of diving when the light comes back, and it's very cold. So it does pose a lot of challenges. The first thing that hits you is just the shock of the cold, and you think, I've got to get out right now. And your head just gets very, very cold, and an ice cream headache. And you descend, and it gets into the green zone, and it's just beautiful then. And on a clear day, it's really quite spectacular.
Here's the dive club where we store our equipment for polar diving, and let me show you one thing first. So this is a most crucial thing on the polar diving. It's a dry suit to keep us warm and protect from the cold environment. So you can see this is a very strong material. It's made on the outside and waterproof materials inside. So then we can get the whole body in, step into that, put the legs first. Then hands with the special silicone cuffs on the hands, so that's watertight here as well. And then eventually the neck goes into this as well, with the silicone rubber around the neck. So then once you zipped you up, you are fully in the bubble. My name is Alexei, and I'm a researcher at the University Center in Svalbard at the technology department. I'm working with sea ice and ice mechanics, and specifically in thermodynamics of ice. I decided to become a diver because I always found it interesting. Diving here in Longyearbyen is quite exotic and hard to reach. So many are attracted by this, to come here and dive in the so exotic and specific place.
And then we have a lot of equipment for cold water diving. So we have regulators that
hopefully won't freeze.
Hopefully won't freeze, yeah. And
we got our dry suits here to
dry suits.
Keep ourselves warm under these. We have a thick layer of undergarment. And then under there, I've got a couple of more layers going.
Yeah.
So
we'll have dry gloves as well. So yeah. Basically the only thing that is exposed to the water is a little bit of skin around our mouth. And that is already cold enough. So we don't want to freeze more than that.
Yeah, I think, you know, the hardest part for me is this is my first dive in the Arctic, and probably going to be the coldest dive I've ever made. So I'm going to take it easy getting in, get used to the water, and then we'll be on our way. Yeah.
So it's probably around 2 degrees centigrade. I don't know what's that in Fahrenheit.
It's about 34. It's exactly 34 degrees Fahrenheit.
Yeah. So it's going to be chilly.
It's balmy.
I'm a PhD student at the University in Tromsø, and I'm studying blue mussels up here on Svalbard. What I'm doing is I'm looking at a species that basically has gone extinct around 1,000 years ago on the archipelago, and now has returned, most likely due to global warming. I have to go diving to find the mussels in the first place. So that's always the first thing we need to do, is get the sample. So in Spitsbergen, we can see a lot of different things on the water, everything from invertebrates to kelp forests to, if we are lucky, even some marine mammals. It was quite special to dive with the harbor seals up in the northwest corner of Spitsbergen. That was very special for me. I didn't expect them to be so curious, actually, that they came over and were biting my fins, and they're just so playful and yeah, very nice to watch underwater.
How was that, Kev?
This 3 to 5 cold water diving for me.
But they were very playful. It was nice.
They were great, weren't they?
Yeah.
So curious. I'm sure it's probably some of the first divers they've had the pleasure of meeting. It's like having two playful ambassadors show you around the park, you know? Really extraordinary.
And it really makes you feel very clumsy.
Yeah.
We are just so slow and they can't move.
They were swimming upside down,
yeah,
all around us, and they would come by completely upside down, turn around, and they would nibble on his fins for a while, and they'd come around and buzz me, and yeah. they were a kick.
I think it's very important that we do these kind of expeditions and also combined with outreach, so that we are actually able to show other people that don't have the opportunity to come here how the Arctic is like, what are the things that change, what is sort of valuable, what should be preserved, and so as scientists we need to collect baseline data to be able to track changes over the long run.
Although I'm concerned about the future of Svalbard, I have hope, because we bring people to a very special place and they get touched by what they see and what they experience here and by each other. And many of them leave this place with a hope to try and do something. And they want to do something and they go home and hopefully they actually act on it and try to do their best to make this place last forever.